So good afternoon. Today we will have the second part related to the optical properties of materials, and we will measure the transmittance and absorbance of films and optical elements, filters and so on. For doing such measurements, we will use a UV visible spectrometer with two beams, okay, and we will start with a brief description of the instrumentation, and then we will perform the measurements. This is the instrument we will use, and now I will show you a little bit how he's in, or what are the main elements in the sample compartment, and then we will measure the sample.
Okay, this is the spectrometer, and this is the sample compartment, okay. And as you can see, there are two positions, the first one for the sample and the second one for the reference. So we have two beams, a reference beam and a signal beam. So in order to show you this feature, I just insert a piece of paper here in front of them. And as you can see, now we have a wavelength of 530, so in the green, and actually you can see the green shape of the slit, okay, for the entrance slit for the two beams, reference and sample. As you can see here, the instruments select the wavelength before the sample. So actually this is the exit, we can call it the exit slit and not the entrance slit. But what we can see is that we just send a single wavelength on the sample. Indeed, if we change the wavelength here from, for example, 530 to 620, so we move to the red, okay. So now we are, and we should see a red spot on the, and indeed you can see here now the color of the entrance slit is red. So basically in this instrumentation we just have to scan, okay, parameters. You can see here we just have to scan the wavelength from the starting wavelength, okay, to the end, and starting one, and also we can choose different slits size. And if you remember, changing the slits width, you can change the resolution and luminosity.
Okay, we are ready and we can measure. Remember that we have two beams, one of the reference and the other for the sample, so it considers the ratio of the two signals, considers all the responses of the light source, of the grating, the detector and so on. We start measuring a simple piece of glass, okay, so without transparent, invisible, and we will measure from 800 nanometer to so at the edge from visible and near down to the UV. So we place simply our sample in front of the signal beam, okay, and now we are ready, okay, so just do this, so you should see the screen, okay, measure sample, okay, from again 1 micron actually, and not 800. Okay, we, as you probably can see, okay, you have a value that are about 91%, okay? It's increasing a little bit. Now it the instrument is changing the grating because it has two gratings, one for the infrared, the near infrared, and one for the visible, okay? And as you can see, the measurement is quite long because it has to scan wavelength by wavelength. These things that are very small in amplitude are due to the defects in the instrument response. Now we are almost 420 at the edge in the violet, at the edge from visible to UV. Okay, now we are going in the UV, but then of course it is possible that the glass, which is transparent in the visible, start to absorb. And we should see a very sharp intense drop off the transmittance. Okay, 40-20, so we are below 300 nanometers and that's it. You see that no transparency here at the... Okay, so the spectrum is finished. Now we can look here at the whole spectrum. Okay, so we have almost 92% of transmittance here in the infrared and visible, which is just it means that we have just the reflection losses on the two sides, 4% and 4%, and then in the UV the glass is opaque and it absorbs the light. Okay, so this is very simple first test. The second sample is a colored filter, which is orange, okay. So we will measure it in starting from 800 nanometers. So just place it in the sample holder, okay. And again, we can perform the measurements. Again, we are starting from 89%, so basically a value which is just a that consider just the reflection losses, okay. And now again some defects to the response. It's orange, so it means that it should absorb in the around 600 nanometers, okay. Indeed, you see now that very sharp drop of transmittance, and now we are 0%. This is the percentage transmittance, okay? Zero. And we the sample will be the same or remains the same until the end in the UV. So I think we can stop here. Yes. And okay. We just overlap to the previous one. You see that we have a small decrease in transmittance in the transparent region. I mean, just few percent, 2%, so nothing. But you see the transition, okay? So due to the fact that the glass is colored, and so it around here we are at about 570, okay? We have the very sharp drop in transmittance. Now we move to another filter glass colored, and now it's yellow. Okay. Again, we can collect the sample and see the differences with the previous one, okay? We start from the same values, 89%, so it means that the glass, glass of the filter is the same as before. And now we should see, okay, the same very small defect. Since it's yellow, the absorption should be more in the blue than the previous one, okay? So we should expect to have a transition at a shorter wavelength. Keep in mind that before the transition was at about 575. Of course, the shape of the curve it is exactly the same as before. Now we see, okay, we are at 450, but since I think 480, the transmission was zero. So we can reach the little bit at the ultraviolet, but we could imagine that here at shorter wavelength the filter is completely open. So we stop. Yes, we add and we see the differences. Okay, this is the yellow. Okay, nice. This is the orange one, this is the yellow one. Okay, so we just see that the threshold transmittance or transparent opaque is just shifted at a shorter wavelength. Here we are at 520 or something, 510. Here we were at 565, okay? So different colors, it means a different absorption transition or threshold in the filter. Now we just take this filter, okay, and we place it, but not at normal incidence, but just tilted, to see if there is an effect of the tilting or the incident angle on this filter, okay? So the next measurement is similar to the first one, but just with the tilted filter. Okay, so we can go back to our screen and see the changes. We are in the red, and now we should start to see the drop in transmittance. And indeed we have. And again we are at zero. Okay, then the spectrum is completely flat. We stop, add, and see the difference. So the idea is to see if we have a big differences in the in placing this the filter, the orange filter, at the normal incidence or tilted in respect to the filter. Okay, just overlap the two. And you can clearly see that we don't have any difference in the transition. Okay, here we have a slightly larger smaller decrease in the transmittance in the transparent region, because the reflection losses depend on the angle. But then you see the transition is exactly the same as before. Okay, after the bare glass and the colored filter, we move now to a multi-layer. This is a sort of cold mirror. Okay, you see that the reflection appears slightly green, yellow. Okay, let's put this filter and try to measure the spectrum. If we place in front of the camera, you can see that the violet light is transmitted, so we should expect a small or high transmittance, because we are measuring the transmittance, high transmittance in the violet. So we place our sample. And we can start. At 800 was 91%, and now it is decreased down to 66, and then go up again. Keep in mind that this is a multi-layer coating, a dielectric coating, so we should expect the oscillations. And this is very similar to the coating we measured with the spectral reflectance last week. Now it's about 550, I think, we see that the transmittance is very low. We are 2%. Okay, is flat again. Keep in mind that since it is a multi-layer coating, the light which is not transmitted is reflected. In the case of the colored filter, the light which is not transmitted is absorbed. Okay, the light goes, the transmittance goes up, and see, we are in the violet and the transmittance is large. This is consistent with the evidence we had before. So a violet color looking through the filter. And then, of course, we have other oscillation in the UV. Okay, so let's see this filter. Okay, this is the filter. We can also compare to the other one. Completely different shape. Of course, this has a bandwidth where the transmittance is low and the reflectance is large, and then some oscillations that gives us the clue that we have a multilayer coating. Now, we did the same experiment as before. So we take this and we tilt in respect to the incident angle. And now we have to look at the transmittance curve and see if it is the same or different in comparison to the first one. So we can perform the measurements. Okay. Again, we see the oscillations, okay, very clear. Now the transmittance goes down. We are in the red and the transmittance starts to be very low. Okay, green. In the violet, we have an increase of the transmittance again, as we observed before. Okay, we finished and we have to compare the two spectra here. Okay, this one, and I just take the other one and place here. Okay. What you can clearly see is that you have a shift of the band changing the incident angle, but this is consistent to the fact that the curve, the transmission curve or the reflection curve, depends on the thickness of the layer. Remember that you have a high reflectivity if you have a stack of layers with a thickness equal to a quarter of lambda. But if we change the incident angle, okay, if we change the incident angle, the real thickness of the layer seen by the light is different. So the interference condition changes, and we have what we see here. So a change in the a shift instead of a change, a shift of the transmittance curve. So it is really important that the dielectric filters are used at a specific or designed at a specific angle. We measure a last sample, which is this glass, and I don't know if you can see, but no, you cannot see very well, but it seems that there is a coating on it, okay? And but from my side, I mean, I just can notice that a coating is on it, but I cannot say anything else. So let's measure and see what is such coating, if I can place it on the instrument. Okay, yes, it should be okay. Okay, we start from 1 micron now. First of all, we notice that the transmittance is very low, 2%. Okay, and it goes down to, okay, very, very low. Okay, now it increases. We are reaching the visible. Okay, now we will see, this is the transition between the two gratings, and you see or listen also the noise due to the change of grating. And then, okay, this transition, and that goes up. Okay, we are going in the visible, and the transmittance increases, and you see here that is very, very low, the transmittance, and now it is almost 80%. Okay, 90, now it goes down, up again. Okay, at this point we are sure that we have a dielectric coating because we have the oscillation. We are more than 90%, so the transmittance is large. Almost 92. We are in the blue violet. Okay, we have this other oscillation, and then we will see what happens in the violet and then in the UVA. Okay, now it starts to decrease the transmittance, and it absorbs in the UV. Okay, this is the spectrum. We overlap to the previous one, and we can see, okay, we can see that the behavior is completely opposite. It is fully transparent in the visible and reflective in the near infrared. So this is a hot mirror. It reflects the infrared and transmits the visible. Okay, so, and this is the opposite. The previous one was a cold mirror, reflect the visible and transmit the near infrared. So of course, for me, since I'm not, we are not sensible to the infrared light, is just a transparent piece of glass with a coating on it. According to the spectrum, we can recognize a hot mirror in comparison to the cold mirror. Okay, so with these examples, I showed you again how the fact that the multi-layer coatings are sensitive to the incident angle, how the presence of oscillations is a clue of the presence of coatings on the glass, and the fact that the colored filter that works in exploiting the absorption and not the multi-layer coatings do not have such filters do not have an impact in the use at the angle you will use.